What's up, everybody? This is Fred Ricciani of TSC News here at Wizard World in Philadelphia, the jam-packed Pennsylvania Convention Center. We got cosplay, comic books, artwork, movie stars, TV stars, even WWE superstars. But let's not waste any time. Let's check out highlights of this awesome event. One of the writers of Team Genesis, and man, can you tell us a little bit about this awesome publication?
Sure. Okay, so people in the world are being born with superpowers and nobody knows really knows why, but everyone wants them on their team. So the governments are recruiting them, individuals, organizations are all recruiting these individuals with these special gifts. So in this issue, Dr. Grant, he's recruiting these five individuals here. They don't know each other. He knows them. And the story is about them coming together as a team. And so for the first five issues, they're not really a team. They're individuals who just now are forced to work together. And so they don't have uniforms yet. They don't have the name Team Genesis yet. So you see the clashing and the likes and the dislikes and all that come about. And other things are going on that forces them to work together. I started working on this story when I was 12 years old. You know, X-Men and Star Trek were like my motivation growing up. I was watching it on television. And so I started writing my own story. And then I let it go because, you know, life took over. And then last year, I had to be on Facebook, ran into some artists, and then Far Corner Studios asked a bunch of people who were interested in starting a comic book to come into a Facebook group. We came into this Facebook group, and they picked us to launch their flagship. And so that's how I was kind of thrown into it.
I've been drawing since I was 4 or 5. When I was 16, inspired by Jim Lee's X-Men in the 90s, I knew I wanted to be a comic book artist. As soon as I graduated high school, I went right into Kubert School, 05 to 08. And ever since then, just been pounding the pavement to get it done. When I was 16 in high school, I decided that. And I organized a comic book club in my school. And we had a small comic convention where J. Michael Straczynski showed up. And he was nice enough to donate some money to our program. And I saw the impact that comics can have on people's lives to inspire people to do good, and I wanted to do that.
You know, I grew up reading comic books, and we went to art school, and I think it was just a natural extension. It's a very easy medium. It's not an easy medium to learn, but it's an easy medium to break into.
I started off as an accountant.
Kind of different.
Yeah, and I just needed a creative outlet, and it started off as a hobby. I went on forums and got a couple of guys together. And we started writing and drawing. And then it kind of branched out from there. I grew up in a lot of 1980s and 90s X-Men. And a lot of 1980s Marvel. So Chris Claremont, Neil Gaiman, Alan Moore, and the like.
For us novices that don't know much about comic book shopping, what's the first thing you should look for?
Well, if you're looking for a bargain, you know, you can look at the dollar books, you know, the boxes and stuff, and then you look at the issues, and if they're backed and board, that's what you want, you know, because that preserves the comic. And then it all depends on which characters you like. You know, if you like Marvel, DC, new X-Men, old X-Men, Spider-Man, Batman, I mean, all, you know, depends on what you like. It's just awesome. You know, I've been collecting for about 30 years, and, you know, I'm actually doing this so I can pay for my kids to go to college. So this is all tuition money.
Besides the great artists and exhibitors of Wizard World, we also got to catch exclusive Q&A sessions with Michael Rooker of The Walking Dead and WWE and Guardians of the Galaxy superstar Dave Bautista. But of course, we can't forget about the best part of Wizard World, cosplay.
The best part of Comic-Con is probably the community. It's the people that you see here, because without these people, there is no Comic-Con. Without everybody here of every shape, size, color, creed, race, there is none of this. So when you come to something like this, look around. Look at the community that you're surrounding yourself in. If you like this type of environment, if you like this type of excitement in your life, come on out. Try it. It's really a lot of fun.
Fred Ricciani, TSC News.